हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू गेट लेटेस्ट वीडियो अपडेट एंड टैप द लाइक बटन। नोवेंजियल कंडेंसेशन रिएक्शन। इट इज़ द रिएक्शन बिटवीन एल्डिहाइड और कीटोन विद एक्टिवेटेड मिथाइलिन कंपाउंड सच एज मेलोनिक एस्टर इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ कैटलिस्ट लाइक अमाइन बेस टू ऑप्टेन सब्स्टिट्यूटेड ओलिफिन एज अ प्रोडक्ट। What are activated methylene compounds? Activated methylene compounds are those compounds in which CH2 group is sandwiched between two strong electron withdrawing group. They are usually two carbonyl group. Here you can see the example. This is the example of activated methylene compound. You can see this carbon with two hydrogen. This CH2 group is present between two carbonyl carbon. And they act as a strong electron withdrawing group. So the carbon which is present in between two strong electron withdrawing group such as carbonyl carbon is called as activated methylene compound, and the hydrogen which are present on these carbon are highly acidic in nature, means it can be easily donated to other compound, because we know that acids are the compound which can easily liberate the H plus or proton. These are the example of activated methylene compounds such as malonic acid, malonic ester, acetyl acetone and malonyl. You can see in all these structure CH2 group is present between the carbonyl carbon. Here you can see in malonic ester, in acetyl acetone also and malonyl also. You can see CN group is there on the both side and CH2, which make this methylene group activated. This is the Jernan-Novengiel condensation reaction where acetone react with malonic ester in the presence of piperidine, which act as a base to obtain substituted olefin as a product. Here this is the carbonyl compound ketone. This is the malonic ester with CH2 group. It is the activated methylene compound. Presence of C double bond OCH3 on both the side. This is the ester group COOCH3, and piperidine act as a base in Novengiel condensation reaction. Let's discuss the reaction mechanism. In first step, the formation of resonance stabilized enolate ion. So here you can see this is malonic ester and this is piperidine. So piperidine act as a base and it will take one of the proton present on this carbon and will acquire positive charge. So here you can see the hydrogen will go on piperidine and NH2 with positive charge. And here the electrons which are present between carbon and hydrogen, it will form a double bond with these two carbon. So the bond between carbon and oxygen will break and oxygen will get a negative charge. Here you can see one of the hydrogen is lost here and it is taken by the piperidine. Double bond formation takes place and the oxygen will get a negative charge. This is the formation of enolate ion. Here you can see the oxygen gets the negative charge and double bond will form between these two carbon. These enolate ion, it exists in three resonating structure. This is the first structure. In second structure, this negative charge will form bond between carbon and oxygen and it will convert into double bond. And this double bond will break and the carbon will take this lone pair of electron and it will acquire negative charge, and this double bond present between carbon and oxygen will break and oxygen will get a negative charge. So this is the first structure. In the second structure, this carbon, here you can see single bond, here double bond formation will takes place, here double bond, it will break and carbon will get a negative charge. So this is the second resonance structure of enolate ion. In third structure, this negative charge on carbon it will form a bond with this carbon, and oxygen with double bond between this oxygen structure and carbon, it will break and oxygen will get negative charge. So here you can see the double bond formation will takes place between this two carbon, and the oxygen will get a negative charge. So this is the third structure of enolate ion. So all these three are resonance stabilized structure, means they are interchangeable. In second step, the enolate ion react with the ketone. So here we can see this is the enolate ion carbon with negative charge. It react with acetone. This is the carbonyl carbon, carbon with double bond oxygen. So this negative charge carbon will form a bond with this carbon. So because of this attachment, this structure will form. So here you can see OCH3 is there, C double bond O is there, and carbon with hydrogen, C double bond O, OCH3. This is the structure, and the acetone, it will attach to this carbon, and you can see this is the acetone part where oxygen will get a negative charge, because this carbon with lone pair of electron will form a bond with this carbonyl carbon. So the double bond present between the carbon and the oxygen will break, and oxygen will get a negative charge. Here you can see oxygen with negative charge. So this is the structure formed in second step. In third step, abstraction of proton from protonated piperidine. In the first step, when the piperidine gain one of the proton and it acquire a positive charge. So here the abstraction of proton takes place from the piperidine. So here you can see oxygen with negative charge and one of the hydrogen, it will form a OH group. You can see here this hydrogen and oxygen with negative charge, it will form a OH group, hydroxy group. So here in the second step, the O minus will take one of the proton and it will convert into hydroxy group. Step fourth is rearrangement reaction, which takes place in the presence of base piperidine. So here you can see the carbon and hydrogen bond will break. Again, this hydrogen will be taken by the piperidine and it will acquire the positive charge. And the electrons which are present between this carbon and hydrogen, they will transfer on this side. And because of this, the carbon-carbon double bond will form. Here you can see the double bond will form between this two carbon. This is the structure. And if the double bond will form, the carbon has four valency. So already due to double bond, this OH has to liberate. So this bond will break and OH minus ion will be liberated. So this is the step fourth where the rearrangement takes place. So this is the end product of Navangial condensation reaction. Reformats key reaction. It is the reaction that used to convert alpha haloester and aldehyde or ketone into beta hydroxy ester using zinc metal as a catalyst in the presence of benzene or ether. So this is ester group R, C double bond O R dash. These two are different alkyl group. Alpha haloester means ester with halide group on alpha carbon. So this is the ester functional group and halide group present on alpha carbon. The product for reformats key is beta hydroxy ester. This is the ester part. This is alpha carbon. This is beta carbon and the hydroxy group present on the beta carbon. So this is alpha haloester and this is beta hydroxy ester. You can see the presence of hydroxy group on beta carbon. This is the general reaction of reformats key. This is acetone when react with alpha chloroester in the presence of zinc metal, benzene or ether and hydronium ion. So this is the product obtained, beta hydroxy ester. Let's start with reaction mechanism. In first step, formation of zinc enolate ion. This is alpha chloroester. It react with zinc metal. So oxygen will form a bond with zinc. The electrons which are present on the zinc will be taken by the oxygen and they will form a temporary bond. Here you can see oxygen with zinc. And because of this, the electrons which are present between this carbon and oxygen double bond, the one of the bond will break and the electrons will transfer on this second carbon and the double bond formation will take place. So because of this, the CH2 group has to liberate this chlorine. Here you can see oxygen form a bond with zinc. Here one of the bond is shifted on this carbon, these two carbon, and the chlorine is liberated. Next, in this structure, this chlorine with negative charge and zinc with partial positive charge. So zinc will attract this chlorine and this ZnCl with oxygen, and this structure is reformat key reagent. Step 2 is the formation of beta hydroxy ester. This is zinc enolate ion. It react with acetone. Here you can see ZnCl will form a temporary bond with this oxygen present on carbonyl carbon of acetone. And here you can see this is the CH3 acetone. Carbonyl carbon present on acetone. ZnCl, they will form a partial bond with this acetone. And here you can see the structure, oxygen and ZnCl, and this double bond present between this CH2 and carbon, it will break and the electrons will utilize for the formation of bond between this carbonyl carbon and this CH2 group. Here you can see the bond formation takes place, CH2 and with this carbon and oxygen with ZnCl. And here this temporary bond is shifted and oxygen will get a double bond with this carbon. This is the continuation of second step. In the second step, this structure was formed. This CH2 form a bond with this carbon, oxygen with ZnCl, and this is the temporary bond between the zinc and this oxygen. When it react with hydronium ion, as we know that hydronium ion can easily liberate one of the proton, so this H will go to this oxygen and it will convert into OH group, hydroxy group. Hydronium ion will convert into water and this ZnCl is liberated. Here you can see. So this is our beta hydroxy ester. This is the reformat key product.